Hello everyone, welcome back to Android Fixation. This is Daryl. Today's video will be a comparison of the Samsung Galaxy Tab 10.1 versus the Toshiba Thrive. We'll start the video with the reigning champion, the Samsung Galaxy Tab 10.1. The measurements of the Samsung Galaxy Tab 10.1 is 256.6 millimeters in length, 172.9 millimeters in width, and an incredibly slim 8.6 millimeters in thickness. It weighs 595 grams. It has a 10.1 inch screen. The resolution of the screen is 1280 by 800. It comes with Honeycomb 3.1. It has a dual core 1 gigahertz Tegra 2 processor. Samsung Galaxy Tab 10.1 comes in 16, 32, or 64 gigabyte versions. On the front of the tablet, we have a front-facing 2-megapixel camera, which takes stills at 1600 by 1200 resolution. On the top of the tablet, we have the power button, the volume rocker, and a 3.5 millimeter headphone jack. On the right side is a stereo speaker. On the left side is a stereo speaker. And on the bottom, we have a 30-pin connector, and we have a speaker. The back of the device, we have the rear-facing 3-megapixel camera, which takes stills at 2048 by 1536, and we have a flash. The Samsung Galaxy Tab 10.1 comes in two finishes, a white and a metallic gray. They both have a metallic silver stripe across the top. This version is a semi-gloss white finish. It's made of plastic, so is the metal. The simulated metal piece across the top is also made of plastic. Here we have the Toshiba Thrive. The measurements of the Toshiba Thrive are 273 millimeters in length, 177 millimeters in width, and a very, very fat 15.8 millimeters in thickness. It weighs 725 grams. It also comes with a 10.1 inch screen. The resolution is also 1280 by 800. It also comes with Honeycomb version 3.1, and it also has a 1 gigahertz dual core Tegra 2 processor. It comes in 8, 16, or 32 gig versions. Looking at the hardware, we have a front-facing 2-megapixel camera that shoots 1600 by 1200 pixels. On the back is a 5-megapixel rear camera. It shoots stills at 2560 by 1920. On the front of the Toshiba Thrive, we see three LEDs, one for the power, one for the battery, and one for Wi-Fi. We have the power button, volume rocker, we have a screen rotation lock, we have a full-size secure digital slot. On the right side of the tablet is a full-size USB port, a full-size HDMI port, and a mini USB port. There's also a 3.5 millimeter headphone jack, power connector, and on the bottom, if I could get it open, there's also a connector similar to the one on the Samsung Galaxy Tab 10.1. It's slightly larger, and we also have stereo speakers on the bottom, one on the left and one on the right. And on the right side, we have the back cover lock. The back covers are replaceable, removable on the Toshiba Thrive. Most of these specs on these two tablets are the same. There are a few areas in which they differ. One of the most noticeable areas in which they differ, other than the size, because we all know that the Toshiba is much thicker than any Android tablet, and the Samsung Galaxy Tab is much thinner than any Android tablet. But other than that, I want you to take a look at the displays on these two tablets. Notice the color saturation on the Samsung Galaxy Tab. You can see the reds, you can see the blues, you can see the green and the yellow. You look at the Toshiba Thrive on the other hand, the colors are very, very washed out. The display on the Toshiba is so poor, I'm starting to believe that I have a defective model. I can't believe that the display is this poor on the Toshiba Thrive. All of the colors look washed out, even whites. Whites on the Toshiba Thrive, they look almost gray. It is a very, very poor display. And I do have the brightness all the way up. So the Galaxy Tab wins in this category, hands down, easily, when it comes to the display. And not only images displayed on the screen look better, but when you turn the cameras on, even though the Toshiba Thrive has a higher resolution rear facing camera, the colors are still washed out, very, very poor, and the Galaxy Tab has much sharper images and takes a much better picture, even though it has a lesser quality rear facing camera. Now, both rear cameras record in 720p at 30 frames per second. The spec sheet for the Toshiba Thrive did not specify if it plays back in 1080p. I searched some third-party sites trying to find out what is the resolution on the playback for the Toshiba, and I could not find any that tells me if it's 720p or if it's 1080p. The Galaxy Tab 10.1 does playback in 1080p. The Galaxy Tab 10.1 has a 16:9 aspect ratio. The Toshiba Thrive, again, I didn't see anything that specified the aspect ratio. I did find on a third-party site that the Toshiba Thrive has a 16:10 aspect ratio. So if it has 16:10 or if it has 16:9, then chances are the playback is going to be 1080p. Another thing I'll notice about the Toshiba Thrive, no microphone. Now, it could be that the microphone is hidden behind these speakers. But when I looked at the spec sheet that came in the box with the Toshiba Thrive, it did not say on that spec sheet that it has a speaker. So can the Toshiba Thrive do video conferencing? Well, it has a front-facing camera, so one would assume that it could. But if it does not have a microphone, how would you hear the person speaking? Does that mean you have to plug a microphone into the headphone jack? Could be. Now, that little symbol there, if you can see it, it shows headphone and it shows microphone. That's a mic underneath the headphone symbol. So, to get sound when you do a video chat on the Toshiba Thrive, you have to plug in a microphone, which means you have to buy an extra accessory. Now, to give the Thrive some credit, we know that it has full-size ports. It has three of them, in fact. Four ports altogether versus none on the Samsung Galaxy Tab 10.1. So if you're looking for a tablet that has expandability, that comes loaded with ports, then by far the Toshiba Thrive is the best you're going to get right now of any tablet, whether it's an Apple tablet or an Android tablet. It has expansions galore. The losing feature on the Toshiba Thrive is the display. I can't get past the display. I could get over the fact that it's thicker. I could get over the fact that it's heavier than the Galaxy Tab 10.1 or other Android tablets. But what I absolutely cannot get over is the display quality. It is so poor that it's very hard to overlook it. When I first turned on the tablet, I was just very, very disappointed, you know, with this display. But I bought it, so I'm stuck with it. I also like the LED indicators here. I wish the Galaxy Tab came with these type of LED indicators here. It's really cool. You can also see the flashing of the ambient light sensor, which the Galaxy Tab does not do. Now, as far as software that came pre-installed, there are two pieces of software on the Toshiba Thrive that set it apart from the Samsung Galaxy Tab as far as pre-installed software. Now, the Tab didn't come with anything as far as games or utilities, but if you look at the Toshiba Thrive, it has its App Store app, has a backgammon app, books, clock, a few card games, Need for Speed Shift, which is a demo. I really wish they would have labeled this demo because I was looking forward to playing this, but it is not the full game, it's a demo. Here's what I want you to take a look at. This print share comes with the Toshiba Thrive. In addition to the print software, it also came with its own file manager. What's neat about the file manager is that it shows you that it can browse more than one type of input. You see internal storage, the secure digital card, and USB. Now, I thought this was so nice, I stripped it and I put it also in the Galaxy Tab. Printer share. And the file manager. And they both work just as well on the Galaxy Tab as they do on the Toshiba Thrive. The difference being the Toshiba file manager, and look, it even says Toshiba file manager, and it's running on the Galaxy Tab. Of course, it can browse internal storage, and it can browse USB storage. However, the Galaxy Tab does not come with a secure digital slot. So when I tap on that, it does absolutely nothing. Later on, I'll find out if I can put a secure digital card into the Galaxy Tab via the USB adapter and see if it works. But looking at it now, it does not. But it works perfectly on it otherwise. The Toshiba Thrive can be made a little bit more appealing by changing the back cover. It has a cover lock. Now, I didn't do a review on the covers and I didn't take the cover off because I just didn't want to spend the extra money to buy a cover just for the sake of doing a review on the cover. But the back cover on the Toshiba Thrive, stock anyway, is nowhere near as nice as the back cover on the Samsung Galaxy Tab. Overall, I do give the Toshiba Thrive high marks for the LED indicators that it has. I also give it high marks for the expansion, which absolutely cannot be beaten. However, the Galaxy Tab 10.1 wins because it's thinner, it's lighter, and the screen is outstanding. Not to mention it has better sounding speakers and it takes better pictures, even though it has a lower resolution camera than the Toshiba Thrive. This is my review, the comparison of the two tablets. Please rate, comment, and subscribe. You can follow me on Twitter at AndroidFixation. And you can also read articles on facebook.com/AndroidFixation. This is Daryl. Thank you for watching. Please rate, comment, and subscribe.